Back to Reconciliation Prep. This week we are on chapter 7, Jesus Helps Us Always. And so our Bible story for this week is going to be one of my favorite miracle stories of Jesus. Jesus helps us in times of trouble, or Jesus calms the storm at sea. It's this cool story where we see a very human Jesus and a very divine, godly Jesus, right? Jesus is in a boat with his disciples and he passed out because he was so tired from all of his walking around and preaching to people and healing them and doing all this cool stuff. So he's passed out in the bottom of this boat and this storm comes up and it terrifies the disciples, but Jesus is sleeping through the storm on a boat. So we know Jesus was a heavy sleeper. They had to wake him up. The storm didn't do it, right? And he gets up and he calms the storm. My favorite line in this whole thing is it says, Jesus gets up and he ordered the wind and the waves to stop, and there was a great calm. Because that's what happens in the Sacrament of Reconciliation. We go into the confessional with this stormy heart, feeling like, I got all this bad stuff that I did. I'm not sure if I'm comfortable saying it to the priest or not. What if he thinks I'm weird? What if he tells my mom? Right, and you go in and he can't tell your mom, by the way. He's not going to think you're weird because you're not going to tell him anything that he hasn't heard. But we all go into the confessional worked up, like, I don't know if I really want to do this or not. And what does Jesus do? He reaches out to us through the priest with the words of absolution, which take our sins away, and he gives us this great calm. The best thing about confession is leaving the confessional afterwards, because you're done. Your sins are gone, right? And so I want you to hear these words of absolution, because these are some of the coolest words you'll ever hear in your life. Remember, you will have just told Father all of your sins that you can think of. And instead of responding to you and saying, you know what, you're a bad person. You shouldn't act like that. Here's what he's going to say to you through the rite of confession. He's going to say, God, the Father of mercies, through the death and resurrection of his Son, has reconciled the world to himself and sent the Holy Spirit among us for the forgiveness of sins. Through the ministry of the church, may God give you pardon and peace, and I absolve you from your sins in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. And then you say amen to receive that absolution. Right, and then at the end, he might say something else to you, and then he'll say, your sins are forgiven, go in peace. That's what happens in the Sacrament of Reconciliation. You get this great calm in the middle of that storm where you feel badly about all these things that you've done. There's this great calm in your heart, in your conscience, with these words of absolution. Absolution is this big fancy word for Jesus taking away your sins through the priest. And so the actual words of absolution are really cool because it talks about that's what Jesus came for. God is a Father of mercies and he sent his Son so that the whole world could be reconciled to him. And so he absolves you of your sins. He takes them away completely and he gives you this great calm.